I will log in as Sunita and I'll pass, my password is library. Okay. Now, what we have done, we have ordered one book to SciTech. We have accessioned also that book and we have received also that book. Now, we have to catalog that book. Am I right? We have to catalog that book. Say for example, if a library is big, some people will do only acquisition, some people will do only accessioning, and some people will do cataloging of those books. Am I right? Or if only one librarian is there, only one person will carry out all the tasks. Okay. Now what we have to do is, we have to go to cataloging. Click on cataloging. All of you are with me? Okay. Click on cataloging. Now which book we had ordered and received, which we have to catalog, because you remember when I ordered the book, I had only entered author name as Wings of Fire and surname as Abdul Kalam. Okay. I had not given the details about publisher of the book, pages of the books, class number of the book, then keywords of the book, or any other details which are available with that book is not done. So we have to do that part. Okay. So when are you all on this screen now? Okay. So there are four options you can see here: cataloging, search, checkout, check-in, renew, and search the catalog. There is a difference between cataloging, search, and search the catalog. Cataloging search means the books which are not yet cataloged. Okay, that is a cataloging search. And books which are already cataloged is, you can search under search the catalog. Then from here you can check out, check in, as well as renew the books for the user. Check out means issue, check in is return. Okay, in Koha issue return is called as check out and check in. Okay. Now we want to catalog the book which we had received from acquisition. Okay. Now I want to search for that book. The title of the book is Wing. Okay. I do not remember the full title. I can just enter the word. Fine. I can just enter the part of the word for that book. All of you could find? All of you have found? Now can you see here, what it says is, one result found in the catalog, zero results found in the reservoir. You can add a new book, you can add new from Z39.50, I will talk about that, and you can merge couple of entries that are available. Now there is only one book which you can see here, okay, and that book we have to catalog. So there is an option here, actions. Is it there an option as an actions? So we can click on actions option here. Okay. Now in the actions option, you can see the mark record, you can see the card preview, you can edit biblio, and you can add edit item. I will explain you what that all mean. As I have told you in the morning, Koha does the cataloging of books using MARC standard. Okay, MARC 21 standard. Okay, Koha carry out the cataloging of books using MARC 21 standard. Now, MARC preview means you can see the details of this book as a MARC record. Card preview means you can really see the old style, the cards which generally gets generated in the library. We will see that. And every cataloging record in Koha is called as biblio. Okay, every cataloging record in Koha is called as biblio. Okay, and attached to one biblio you can have several items attached. If you remember, I had mentioned in the morning that one cataloging record, like for example, for this Wings of Fire, I can have a book, I can have a CD of this book, I can have a DVD of this book, I can have a tape, or I can have some other a map or anything. So, all of them, if I want to attach to this record, they all are called as items. Okay, they are all called as items. Right now, we just want to do the cataloging of book. So, what we have to do is click on edit biblio. Click on edit biblio. Okay, all of you click on edit biblio. Now, what does I mean by edit biblio is, I am going to enter the details of the book for the cataloging purpose, okay, for the cataloging purpose. Those who are doing cataloging in the library, they will have to click on edit biblio and edit the cataloging data for all the books. Now, when you are editing the books, you have, as I have said, you have a sheet which gives you mark tags, okay, these are all mark tags. So, mark has 952 tags and each tag is subdivided with 0 to 9 and A to Z, okay. So, that means mark expects you to catalog a book with 952 entries. Does any library will have time? Nobody will have time. What we are going to do is, we are going to enter the data into only the required tags which we are going to use for our library. We will not have time to enter all this information for one book. That means you will need several librarians to catalog books which are received for your library. So, at the moment, I will show you which are important tags which needs to be entered when Koha is used for your library and which are where you have to do the data entry, okay. So, let us now first click on, you are on the zero tag. I will try to give you one by one the details about the tags which are important. Now, see in the 00 tab, if you scroll down, okay, what is important is, if you remember, I have mentioned this, 0 to 0 is for ISBN number, okay. So, you have to enter, again very important part I must tell you here, if you wrongly enter the ISBN number, on your opaque page, the cover page will not be displayed properly. So, you, if you want to show the cover pages of the books properly on your opaque, your ISBN number should be correctly entered here, okay. So, what I will do is, I will try to find out ISBN number from the Google for this book and we will see how to enter the ISBN number. Let me just find out, you do not do anything, I will just find out. So, what I am doing is, I will go to Amazon. There are two ways by which we can also catalog the book. I will show you one by one. Okay. Now, I will search for a book and I will search for Wings of Fire. Okay. I will have to give the author name also. Advanced search. Fine. Now, when I have the book in my hand on the screen, the ISBN number for this book is, I will take the 13 digit number, I'll copy from here, but I can repeat for all of you so that you can enter it in your Koha. Okay, so all of you please enter this number 978-817-317-11466. Okay, all of you have entered. So, whenever you are cataloging any book, first thing is try to identify the ISBN of the book so that you enter the ISBN on the 00 tab. Okay. Now, when you scroll down, now we will also change that, but anyway, right now by default we have enabled duodecimal classification. We want to also enable UDC. I will show you in the next screen how to enable. But if you enter the call number gets entered in $082A, but later on we are going to change it to 080. because 080 is for universal decimal classification. We have not enabled that, we will enable that, but 080 is for universal decimal classification. So if I give this book as an some number, say 800, and item number for this book is say ABD Abdul Kalam, okay. So how will I enter my call number 800 ABD, okay, fine. Now in this zero tab, one more option is there which all of you have to remember, the language code. That means if the book is written in other language than English, you can enter the details of the language here, okay. If it is in Marathi, if it is in Hindi, if it is in Tamil, I can add either ENG or MAR or Bengali, if it is in Bengali BEN. So right now anyway it is in English, so I will add English as a language code, okay. Are you all here? Everybody is with me? Okay. So in the zero tab, what are the important things we have written? Again, few more things we have to enter. We have entered the language code. We have entered the ISBN number. We have entered the classification number and the item code. Now there is one more option. It is asking for transcribing a cataloging source. Okay. In $040 C, it asks you who is doing the cataloging of this book. So tomorrow if I am going to share all the records with various libraries across the world, I will be able to identify the library from who has done the cataloging. So at the moment transcribing agency is who? IIT, because IIT library staff is doing the cataloging. So what I am going to write here is IIT. Okay, IIT library. I will also show you one more where we have to enter. All of you are here? Okay. Now when you scroll up, one more area is there. Fine. Anyway, that we will talk later. Now come back to one. Okay. Here we all enter the details about the authors. Okay. In the tab number one, we enter details about the author. So if a book has more than one author, first author will be entered in $100 A and rest of all the authors will be entered in $700 A, okay. Right now we know that this book is only one author, no, there is one more author, Tiwari Arun and Abdul Kalam APJ. So in the my author entry, what I have to write? Abdul Kalam comma APJ. Okay, in my author $A, 100 is what? Abdul Kalam APJ is my $100 A entry. There are two authors for this book. So second author we will enter in $700 A. Okay, right now we have entered in $100 A. Okay, all of you have done. Now we will go to the option 2. Okay, we are going to option 2. In 245 title statement, what is the title of the book? Wings of Fire. And this is a subtitle, an autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. So how will I enter that? Wings of Fire colon and the remainder is an autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. Fine. Everybody has entered. Okay. Now we want to enter if there is any edition attached to this book. That edition details are attached in $250 A. But right now there is no edition for this book, so we will not enter any details here. But the other details like where this book is published, who is the publisher of the book and when this book is published, all these details we want to enter. So I'll just check what are the publishing details. It is published by Sangam Books, then maybe 1999, okay. So I am saying here, maybe New Delhi, okay, then Sangam Books and date of publication 1999, okay. Fine, all of you have entered. Now we will go to tab number 3. In the tab number 3, you have to enter the page numbers of the books, of the book. A book has initially say 10 pages and total 350 pages. How will you enter? XVI comma 300 pages, okay. In the 3 tab, you are going to enter page numbers. All of you have entered, okay. So we have entered page numbers in the $300 A tab. Now if the book has any series attached to it, that series detail you can add in tab number 4, okay. That tab number 4 is a series statement. Can you see on your screen? That 440 tab is now actually not valid, okay. So you have to enter the series details in $490 A. So $490 A will give the say textbook of modern physics volume 1. So those series details will go into 490. Anyway, this book does not have any series, so I am not adding any series. Now if the book has to, we have to give the keyword for the book. In the 5 tab we are not adding anything, okay. Now if we want to give the keyword for the book, keyword will be entered in $650 A, okay. Now very important is biography. See, there is one very good option which is available. I am giving a general keyword as biography, and biography of an Indian. So there is an option here, geographic subdivision, biography of Indian. So there is an option here as biography of Indian. So I can say here biography and Indian as a keyword, okay. You can give as many keywords you want. Again, there are some tabs, they are repetitive tabs, some cannot be repeated, but anyway right now we don't go into those details. Everybody has entered. Now we can go to the 7th tab. This tab gives $700 A is for additional author entry, okay. So if I have more than one author, what is the name of the author? Second author is Tiwari Arun, okay. So how will I enter Tiwari Arun as Tiwari Arun? $700 A is for second and all the remaining authors. So if a book has more than 3 authors or 2 authors, all the additional authors will be entered in 700 tab, okay. All the additional authors will be entered in 700 tab. Everybody has done. Now we have to go to 9 tab. All of you are here. In the 9 tab, it is asking you what is the item type. What is the item type? It is a book, okay. Done. Now try to save this. Now what we have done is we have created a cataloging record of a book which we have accessioned and one book which we received. But when we had ordered the book, we did not know the details about the book, like who is the publisher, what is the publication year, what are the pages, all those details we have tried to enter. Now try to save. Now it is still saying some of the tabs are not important. Say okay and take your cursor again to 0 and then only press it once. That I wanted to tell you, correct. I have to change that, okay. Okay, all of you are here. We need to do small correction here. So in the control number identifier, all of us will enter here IIT. Now again I will tell you what does it mean. I completely missed this. Okay, in the control number you have to enter as IIT. Fine? All of you have done? Now you try to save this record. So once you save the record, you should be able to see on the right hand side why the photograph is not visible. ISBN is given correctly. Okay. Are you all able to see here? Now I think I should also see the photograph. Let me check. There may be an issue. By default, if the ISBN number is written correctly, like here, okay, on the right hand side, you should be able to see the cover page of the book immediately. But for that, your computer connects to the Amazon server and then bring the cover page and display it here. So anyway, if your organization does not block any sites, you should be able to see. Probably I can quickly show you from my site. Okay, so maybe when I search for organic chemistry, see here. So we have enabled Amazon, so it is showing you me the cover pages on the right hand side, okay, on my NCL library side. So similarly for all of you also, it should be able to show you the cover pages on right hand side, okay. Anyway, that is only question of computer division adjustment, otherwise all of you could have seen here the cover page at the right hand side. Now I just want to check whether Z39 is working. Did they make any change? Not working? Fine. Anyway, I will explain to them at least. Now for some reason, whenever IIT library will open your Z39.50 server, in that case, what you can do is, you can search for the title, like just Wings of Fire. You can find the entry in the Library of Congress and you can just download that complete cataloging record into Koha. So you do not have to do any cataloging at all, okay. So author name gets entered, title gets entered, publisher name gets entered, year gets entered, page numbers get entered. So everything is entered automatically and you do not have to do any cataloging. Classification number also you get from Library of Congress. So you save lot of your time and then you achieve standardization, because while typing manually, as a librarian or as a human, I can make any mistake, okay, Abdul Kalam, I can type wrongly also. So when the user is trying to search for the same book, he may not find the book, though Koha has a very good search feature available. But if you connect to the Library of Congress, you do not have to do any data entry manually, okay. How that works basically, though it is not working at the moment. So for example, if you are going in a cataloging, I think we tried last time this, okay. So if I click on Z39.50 and I can search for any title, say Introduction to Radio Astronomy, okay, I can search for a data record from here, and if it is there available in Library of Congress, I can just import that record. Anyway, it is connection timed out, it is not working. So I can just download that record from Library of Congress. Let us add one more book in Koha and then we can learn how to use the circulation module. So if at all now, imagine a scenario, I want to add one more book in Koha which is already accessioned by my library and I am doing the retrospective conversion. Retrospective conversion means I am not using acquisition module at all. I directly want to catalog the book and accession the book, okay. So how I can do that? Let us try to click on new record and click on books, okay. We have clicked on new record and books, okay. Now what we are going to do is, if you remember, we will be now going to add, first of all, what is the, we have to add ISBN number, right? So what I will do is, I will again search for one more book in Amazon. Fine, I have found one book, Introduction to Digital Libraries by Chaudhary GG, okay. So and the ISBN number for this book is, let me copy the ISBN number and then I will tell you all of you. So first entry I have to do is the ISBN number, okay. So for this book ISBN is 9781856044653, okay. All of you have done. Now we have to give, who is doing the cataloging? IIT library, fine. Then what is the call number? Again I am doing it some random call number. Chaudhary is CHO, fine. So what I have done, I am trying to create new cataloging record of a book for an old book which is available in my library, and I am trying to catalog that book and accession that book. Now I am not using acquisition module at all because the book is already purchased in the library. I want to catalog that book, okay. Now how I can do that? Now I will come in the tab 1. What is the author name? Author name is Chaudhary Gigi, okay, and Sudatta is another. So first is Chaudhary Gigi, okay, my $100 A, okay, $100 A is my author name. What is the author name? Chaudhary Gigi. Now in the title, $245 A, what is the title? Introduction to Digital Libraries. Name of the author title is Introduction to Digital Libraries. Does this book has any subtitle? There are no subtitle for this book. And who is the publisher? Facet Publishing, okay. So what I will enter here, place is again I will say New Delhi, and name of the publisher is Facet Publishing. Year is 1999, okay. All of you have entered? Everybody has entered? Now we will try to add pages. So again some XX and 304 pages. Everybody has entered? Now again I will give the this book as a $650 A. My keyword is digital libraries, okay. Everybody, now in the 700 tab I want to enter second author, am I right? Who is my second author? Chaudhary Sudatta, okay. So $700 A, Chaudhary $700 A is Chaudhary Sudatta, okay. All of you are here. So if more than three authors, this is a repeatable tab, okay. I can repeat this. I have got a free blank again form here, okay. This is a repeatable tag. Now if this book is available free online, I can provide the URL of this book here, where I can provide $856 U. It's called as Uniform Resource Identifier. So if the library has purchased the ebook of this print copy of the book, I can provide the URL of this book so that people can click from here and read the book online, okay. So $856 U is for providing the URL for the book if the book is available online, okay. Let me see whether this book is available online. You have everything of Emerald, okay. Say for example this book has this URL, anyway you do not do anything. Does this has a URL? Anyway, you can add that later, you can find and enter. Now we can go to 900 tab and what is it? Book, okay, select as a book. Now I will come here. All of you have entered all these details. Now try to save. Again it will say 000005 and 008, okay. So 000005 and 008, okay. Now try to save this record. Now once you have saved this record, now we want, have you got this screen now? Everybody has got this screen. Now what we have to do is very important is, what is the shelf number, where the book will be kept, what is the call number and what is the accession number. So these are some of the important things you have to add for every book that is added in your library, okay. So we are going to do the retrospective conversion or cataloging of a book available in the library through cataloging module. I have not used acquisition module because the book is already purchased some time back, okay. So what it is asking me, if the book is lost, I can give the withdrawn status or a withdrawal or lost, then what is the classification which is used for this book. We will change that later, I forgot to, we will do that. Now where is the shelving location? Now this shelving location is, by default Koha has given these shelving locations, but if you want to add your own shelving locations, just now he showed me shelf number 1, rack number 1, shelf number 2, rack number 2, shelf number 3, rack number 3. All these details you can add here, so that for every title you can select the shelving location so that the book can be retrieved in your library easily, okay. By default these options are available, but you can always change these options as per your library requirement. So this shelving location, you can add your library shelving location options as you wish. Koha has given these by default: audio visual, book card, children's area, fiction, general stacks. You can remove all this and create your own shelving location as you have said, shelf number 1, rack number 1. So you can add like that and select. Automatically Koha will give the detail for that book, exact location of the book, okay. Right now anyway I will just say general stacks, because anyway I do not know where it is kept. Now if the book is acquired earlier, I can change here the date. So what I have to say, suppose it was purchased in 2000, okay, October, 2nd October 2000, I can add that date here, okay. Now here again important part is, because you are doing retrospective conversion, from where this book was purchased, because you know, you know that it was purchased from say Allied Publishers or Universal Book Agency. So what you can add here is Universal Book Agency, bill number 123, dated 2nd October 02. Fine. So what I have done, I have tried to add my acquisition details for a book which was procured in 2000, and I am going to catalog that book now for the in Koha, okay. Now very important is, there are two costs: cost normal purchase price, and there is one more cost, cost replacement price. Replacement price means the actual cost of the book, that means the publisher version of publisher cost, and purchase price means the library has got some 15% discount and then the cost. So if you remember, for our Wings of Fire, book was say for 2500 and we got the book, actual price was for 2000, okay. And you don't have to add any currency symbol here. Currency is automatically identified as the active currency rupee. You don't have to add any currency symbol here, okay. So what I have added, replacement price is actual price of the book before discount, and purchase price is the after discount price, okay. These are, then shelving control number also you can add. Right now there is nothing, but you can add that data also here. Now you have to give the accession number of the book. Now imagine that book has already accessioned, so it may have some number as say IIT 400 4000, because I am doing the retrospective conversion of the books, so the book already has some accession number. I can provide the accession number here. Okay, all of you have done. Can you see here call number 560 CHO? Automatically it has come. We entered it into 082. Okay, that is mapped here. Okay, automatically it has come here. Now you have to only say add item. Okay, so what we have done, we have added one more book into Koha, the retrospective conversion of the book. Have you all understood, everybody? So let us all of you try to search the book in your OPAC. Now let us see how the OPAC works. Okay, or let me show you. I will ask you to do later, so I will just say digital. Oh, now it is coming. Probably then ISBN is wrong. So Koha is not picking up that ISBN. So now you can see Google, it is taking from Google. Okay, so it is taking the cover page for the book from Google. Okay, I will show you on OPAC how to search. We will take the OPAC class, give me a minute. But see now how nicely all the data is displayed for one book. Now what I want to do is, I want to issue one of this book to one more borrower. I will create so that all of us understand how circulation module works. Have you understood how cataloging works for the books? Everybody is clear? Now let us add one more user and try to issue the one of these books to that user so that we can do the circulation module. So what we are going to do now is, we go to our Koha. All of you are here. We will go to home. Please go to home. Everybody is gone to home. Now click on Koha administration. Now we again click on patron categories. Now we are going to create one patron category as student. Okay, we will create one patron category as students. Okay, so click on new category. Now the category code is student. Fine. Student is the category and description is IIT students. Now you can also create categories as first year student, second year student, third year student, fourth year students. That also you can create the categories. Okay. Now again I will give the validity for all these students is 12 months. Fine. Now again here also age restriction may be 18. Am I right? 18 minimum age. 60 is their upper age limit, not 60, 25. Okay. Do you want them to send overdue notices? Yes. Now here, what is the category type here? As an adult. You are going to select as an adult, not the staff. Okay. Now they are adult. See, we are going to create category as student. Everybody is with me? IIT students, 12 months. Age required 18, upper age limit 25, category type as adult. Everybody is here. Now it is asking me whether this type of categories should be received, what kind of emails, whether they should receive item due mail, yes, whether they should receive advance notice, any hold they have placed, item check in, item check out. That is a librarian's decision to select which emails these type of students should receive. Okay, everybody is with me? Save. Fine. All of you are here. Now for this category we have to set rule for issuing. Okay, we have to set the rules for issuing. Click on circulation and find rules. See, what I asked you to create one patron category. You have done the category. Which category we have created? Category as students. Okay, category as student. And I provided them, managed to create. Anyway, then circulation and fine rules. Okay, now we are going to select the circulation rules for the student category first. So what is the patron category? IIT students. Fine. Now what type of items they can borrow from the library? Either I can say all, or I can right now select book. I can select book. Okay, current checkout allowed, I will say only one because we are learning. Checkout allowed means how many books students can borrow. Okay, then current on site, anyway we are not going to bother about on site part. Then the book, how many days book is allowed to be borrowed? How many days do you allow? 30 days. Okay, 30 days. Then if you are charging the fine, if the books are not returned, how much fine do you charge? So if say 1 rupee, I will say 1. Fine. Now once you have set the fine, do you charge every day? Fine charging interval, that means every day you are going to charge. If I say 1, that means every day the fine will be charged. When to charge? Start of interval or end of interval? End of interval. Fine grace period, that means if the my due date is after 30 days, immediately on 31st day computer will start charging the fine. But I can provide 2 days grace period and then start charging the fine, so that on 33rd day fine will be started calculating. So I will give a grace period of 2 days. Okay, then overdue fines cap amount, this is very important. Now for this category, computer should calculate fine up to what amount? There should be some cap, right? Limit. So we can provide here 1,000 rupees, 2,000 rupees, some amount cap. Okay, so I can say 2,000 rupees. Fine. Now suspension we will not. Renewal allowed count. Okay, how many times this user can renew the books? Okay, let us say 2. Now if the renewal is allowed, how many days the renewal? Again for 30 days? Do you allow again for 30 days? Okay, so renewal is allowed for 30 days. Okay, now automatic renewal, that means whether you allow users to on their own to renew books or computers should automatically renew, we do not allow that. Okay, now holds allowed, how many holds they can put up? Let us say 2. Okay, and now what is important? On shelf item level holds, blah blah blah, we don't do anything, save. So what we have done, we have set up a rule for students category to borrow books from the library, and we have allowed them to borrow one book right now. Okay, you can check that. Now let us add one borrower first as a student. So how we can do that? Click on patrons. All of you have clicked. Now new patron. Now click on new patron. Now we have to select the category, IIT students. Okay, now let us add one name of the student. Okay, I will add some Mr. Prasad ARD. Fine. Initial date of birth is 18 July 1994, initials is ARD. Okay, are you all here? Yes or no? Then email address ard@yahoo.com. Fine. Then his card number, I have added some 3456 as his card number. Everybody is here. Then the library. Then category, now you have to remember which category? Students category. Then you have to provide ARD login and password. So I will say ARD as the username, password again library. ARD as username and password again as library. Save. Fine. Everybody is here. All of you are here. Now we want to attach a photograph of ARD here because we have enabled that image photograph. Okay. Now what we can do is imagine that you may have the photographs on your USB drive, but at the moment we can find the ARD's photograph on your Google and try to attach. So all of you please enter on your screen one more tab, open a one more search tab, Google. Everybody has opened one tab. Now search in the search box, search ARD Prasad. And click on image or anyway that is there. Everybody is here. What I am going to do is I will save this photograph as save image as ard.jpg. Okay, and I will say save. Now on my Koha, what I will do is browse and downloads and here open and upload. Okay, so I can see the ARD's photograph here in my circulation part. Okay, those who have internet, please try to upload the photograph of that patron. No need to upload ARD's photograph, you can have your own photograph if available somewhere on internet. Who all could do this? Shall I repeat? Then no issue, then it won't work. If net is not there, then it will not work. Fine. So this is how you can upload the images of patron. Now this I have shown you individually one by one, but in the Koha there is an option to upload all the images, all the patrons in one go. You don't have to enter manually. That Excel sheet if you generate, that will upload all the photographs, all the patrons, everything. Okay. Now let us try to issue one book to ARD. Okay. So we will click on checkout. Are you all here? We will click on checkout. Now we will search for ARD and we will try to issue one book to ARD Prasad. Now here the option is enter item barcode. Okay, enter item barcode. So let us enter IIT1. Have you all entered? Check out. So now once you click on checkout, it is saying one checkout. Show checkouts. When you click on show checkouts, this book will be shown. Okay. Now Wings of Fire is due, when it is due? 2nd May. Okay, it is due 2nd May. Fine. So that is how it will also show you how many renewals are allowed, then what is the cost of the book. So that is how the circulation module works. Okay, now I just want to show you. Everybody has issued one book to ARD? Who has not? Because I want to take you to the OPAC page. Who has not done? Please raise your hand. Okay. Now log out from your staff client. Everybody has logged out. Now I want to ask you all, everybody is with me here on this screen. Now I will try to log in with ARD and library as a password. This should work. I am trying to add ARD and library. Will this work? So I have not given any permission to ARD because ARD does not have any business to work in staff client. Who is ARD? He is only a student. What he can do? Only he can borrow books and journals. He does not have any role to play in this page. But ARD can log in through OPAC page. Okay, here it has not worked. But if you open your OPAC, for me it is 152:8000. Just open up your OPAC page. All of you please open your OPAC page. Do you know how to get your OPAC page? You have to type your IP /OPAC. Everybody? All of you are here? Now we are learning the OPAC module. Now you ARD is going to log in with his account on OPAC page. How he can log in? There is an option here. Can you on your screen see login option? Jis kisi ka login aur password hai, log out karo. I am going to type ARD and password as library. Are you all here? Say login then. Login with your OPAC. Now what all happens? Okay. Now what all is happening on OPAC page? Let me tell you now. Now you are logged in as ARD Prasad. Now here it allowed to log in because no, it is not allowing. Why? Password is wrong. You have made some mistake. Now on the OPAC page, everybody has right to see the OPAC with their login and password. Whether he is a library staff or a user of the library, he can see. What all he can see, ARD can see on the OPAC page, none of the library software which are developed in India, you can correct me if I am wrong, whether it is a Libsys or Slim or any other, they do not give the details about login and password. You can check how many books have been issued on your name. You can check your fines. You can check your, you can change your password. Now you can suggest book online, okay? So what all you can do in your OPAC page? You can do many things in your OPAC page. You have logged in as ARD. Hello ARD Prasad, am I right? ARD can see how many books he has borrowed from the library, when they are due, okay, when they are due, as well as he can see the fines. If any fine is due to him, he can check the fine. And one more thing ARD can do is, now ARD if searches for any book and that book is not found in the OPAC page, he can put up a request for the book from here itself. Let us click on your purchase suggestions. Please enter. All of you have entered. Now click on new purchase suggestion. Everybody has clicked. Now ARD has searched for some book and he did not find the book in the library. What ARD can do is, ARD can send a request for the book from the OPAC page itself. He does not have to re-email the librarian, he does not have to call the librarian either or anything. He has to go to the OPAC page and he can put up a request. So let us try to add one book, Introduction to Radio Astronomy. Okay? ARD only knows the title, ARD does not know anything. Okay? So ARD can only decide whether, what is it, it is a book. Okay, and reason for suggestion, that also we can change, but upcoming a popular title. And what ARD has done, ARD is trying to suggest a book for the library. Okay, the title of the book is Introduction to Radio Astronomy. Item type is book, reason is upcoming title by popular author, and submit suggestion. Fine. So what has happened is, as somebody asked me, he asked, no, that if there are 100 books, status will get changed as soon as the library takes action. Okay? Right now it is requested. Librarians will get a message now that ARD has suggested a book. as soon as librarian order the book, the status will change here, and ARD also will receive an email that book is ordered. Okay, but those all settings will have to be done, but then everything is taken care. Okay, now what all you can do in the Koha is, I just want to tell you what all Koha can do. As a library counter, if you are sitting on the library counter, you can help users to search for the books, and Koha has a very good search engine because it uses Zebra as a search engine. So you can click on advanced search option. Can you all click on advanced search option? When you click on advanced search option, what you can do is, you can make the combination. So there is a very good Boolean logic combination which is available, by which you can carry out searches and help your users when they come to the library and if they do not find any books. So what all combinations you can do is, one more I do not know, but you can search by accession number also, that is called as barcode in Koha. You can search by keyword, title, author, publisher, all these. Then you can also restrict your searches based on books or serials. Then still you can restrict your searches based on language or date range or relevance. There are still more options. So Koha has a very good search facility. Okay, so basic search and advanced search is an excellent feature which is available in Koha, which allow you to narrow your searches. Otherwise, if I just say organic chemistry, I will get thousands of books. Then I can customize my search organic chemistry from 1990 to 1999. I will get still less number of hits. Again, I can say I want to only search for all the books available in the library by author Barve. So again, the number of hits will be less. So the Koha has very good search facility by which you can help user. One more thing which I had mentioned to you is, if you remember, as I have logged in as ARD, and when I am in, say for example, if I find the Wings of Fire book, okay, pay attention, then you can explore this. Okay, if I search for Wings of Fire, now as an ARD, if you remember, I had shown you this. I have given this book as a keyword as what? Biography India. If ARD does not like this keyword which librarian has given, ARD wants to classify or give keyword as per his interest. So that is called as tagging in Koha. Okay. So if I click on add tag, I can enter the keyword for this book as I wish. Okay. So I will not say as a biography, I will say Indian history, because I think that Dr. Kalam is talking more on Indian history in this book, and I will say add. So ARD can go on adding the tagging of the books as he wish. Okay, so if he finds lot of books in the library, and as per his view, the book should have keyword not as biography India but Indian history. So he can go on adding, and you, can you see tags added one. Okay, so that is how Koha has a feature that you can add the classific keywords to books. Everyone can do that. Now what all ARD can do? ARD can place hold, ARD can generate the list and print, ARD can save the list, and ARD can save records and share with the colleagues. So OPAC has many features. Okay, you can generate lot of list and share with your friends through OPAC. You don't have to go to the library for those things. So as I have said, Koha OPAC has many features. Anyway, I'll log out right now from here. Everybody is here. Now come back to your Koha page. Please come back to your Koha page. What is that IP for your Koha page? 8001. Okay. All of you are here? Everybody is here? Now I want to show you. Everybody can come back to their Koha client page and log in with their login and password. Have you seen any change on your screen? Suggestion pending approval. Yes. Okay. So now the librarian has to order this book. As soon as the librarian order this book, again it will be intimated to ARD that book is ordered. When book receives, again intimation will go to ARD that book is received in the library. Okay. So these are some of the good features which Koha has.